Question number 6 of the PhilNITS FE afternoon portion of the exam. In this question, we are now in number 6 and we have to do the next set of sub-questions, sub-question B and sub-question C. Actually, the naming they use is group B and group C for sub-question 1. And in this question, we have to, or in this set of questions, we have to work on step 2, where it says determine the starting position of each data value in an output sequence. I think when I was doing this yesterday afternoon and also yesterday morning, this part, I think what I focused more was this one, step 2. And not too much about the other words here, because we need to identify which part of the program is it referring to. And also, I was doing this in the afternoon too, because in the morning, if you have to work on something about arrays, which are containers of containers, where you gotta have some kind of mental map where they are, identifying the locations and things like that. And at the same time, you got telephone calls ringing and you have to answer those, and people asking you questions as well. Not to mention the excess noise. It's really difficult to continue on working on this. And that's why I think that this is an observation that we can definitely make use of to understand how people think and how memory works, especially with people who may have problems remembering stuff or recognizing things. I think it's definitely has some sort of relationship with the way people, for example, create a mental image of where things are, and using that part of the brain to create multiple, in this case, arrays, containers of containers, and then thinking about how each one relate to each other and where is this particular item in the map, okay? So I think the way to answer this is to, of course, look at the set of sub-questions and the answer group for the particular question that we are aiming for. For example, for answer group B, we do have these choices. And if we look at the program, which says here step 2, we see that there's a blank for group B and a blank for group C. Now, what we need to do is put the correct set of variables, set of expressions, equations that would fit in B and C. And I think the way I answered this was to first eliminate the ones that seemed to be obviously incorrect. And I knew that these choices A and B are incorrect, because if you look at this part here, where I've put a handwritten note on the two arrays, the two containers of containers that we are investigating, we'll see that there's definitely a kind of pattern that we could find, and I think that's one of the indications that if there are patterns here, then there would be choices that would be too far off from what we're going for. And what I did was, for example, in this case, we see that if the first part of the program is saying that we go through the counting from I0 to I less than 11, or what that means is we count until I is 11, because if it's less than 11, then we can continue on with the counting. Otherwise, we stop. So that means that we are counting only until 10. And then it says here, this part, where if, for example, count I, the value of that count is greater than 0, then we can go into this part here inside the if statement. So this count, by the way, I think it's also important that we understand what's count and then what's index. And I think that's explained somewhere up above here, where you got the count as an array, a container of containers, and it's supposed to count the number of occurrences of each data value. And here I put exam score to give an example of a data value, because sometimes, just like in my case, I couldn't really understand rather clearly what is being counted here. And so by giving an example like an exam score, we have an idea that will help us understand what we need to do. Now we have to count the occurrences of each score. And if we look at the scores that are here, we get 7, 8, 5, the maximum is 10. And it's from here, we can see that there are those that have the same scores, like 8 and 8, 7 and 7, right? And again, the range is between 0 and 10. Now, what we need to do is to count how many of the 7s appeared, how many of the 8s appeared, and from where, from there, we can create the count array. And then the index, the next array that we are interested in, is saying that for the array of index indices, let's see. Again, we have here a data value with which pertains to the exam score. And then what we need to do is to calculate the lowest storing position of each data value in the output arrays and store the result in the array index as shown below. So what that means is, if you got the index array like this, what we need to do is to store, let me see. Okay, so for example, if the data value is saying it should be, let's see if what the scores are. So we got 8, 7, 5, and 6, and 4. 7, 8, 5, like that. Then if the lowest score is 1, then we put it here like this, and then 2, 3, 5, 8. And in that way, we can create the index. Okay, so we stored the lowest, we calculate the lowest storing position of the score. And then we get the result in this way. Okay. Now, if we put them in a diagram together, and while remembering that there's this portion here inside the loop, or inside the loop, but also inside the if statement, we would have this type of pattern where the indices we have here, which will be the labels of the containers, so that we know which one we're referring to. So if it's 0, then that's the first one. The label 1 would tell us that it's the second one, because we're starting with 0. Now, if the count is here, the how many times the score appeared, and the index is here as well, which should pertain to the scores. And if they are aligned in a certain way that the numbering of the containers are like so, then can we see any patterns? And one pattern that I saw was if we add 1 and 0 together like this, we get 1. And at the same time, if we do it to the other one, to the next one, 1 plus 1 is 2, 1 plus 2 is 3, 2 plus 3 is 5, and 3 plus 5 is 8, and 2 plus 8 becomes 0 at the end here. But I think it's pretty much a pattern that we can observe, and that's why when I was doing the first set of answer group, we see here that I eliminated I and also this one, because if you put I, whatever value the I is, then this pattern wouldn't really make sense. It won't appear at all. So I was able to eliminate I, which we need to put for index, because if we're now in 4, then this should be 4, but it's not 4. So it's quickly eliminated. Now for I plus count I minus 1, you also do the same thing. You put in the values and see what the result would be for index. And if it's I minus 1, 3, then you get the value is 0. And then I, so that would be 0 plus 4. But again, the value here is not 4, it's 0. So this one quickly eliminates these two. The problem we had was whether it should be this one or the other one, the two remaining choices. And I chose the one with the n plus count bracket I minus 1 because I thought that it's the correct answer after putting in values. But it turns out that once you reach, I think, 7, it starts to break down. It doesn't give you the correct numbers anymore later on. And still, I think I was able to arrive with the correct answer for letter C by also looking at the inputs and also the outputs. And it seems like for letter the group B, it could be N or N plus count bracket I minus 1. That would be the answer if I chose for the next set of answers for question C, this one, the count bracket I. And again, also we can eliminate the other ones very quickly, because if the blank C is supposed to have this statement together with it, n is equal to n plus something, and we put in I or index I and score I, we'd also get incorrect values. So turns out that if we put in another array like so, then if we get the value of n to be count I, then I think we would be able to arrive with this pattern that we see here. For example, if we have, for example, we are now at 4 because we have to look at if it's greater than 0, the value of count. And then if we see the set of instructions again, the index would be the value here, 0, and then n would be, if it's count I, would be 1, and that's why we get 1 here. Now if you go on and move on to the next one, we'll see that we'll get 2 because the count is 1, and then we add this one with the previous value of count, which is also 1, and so that's why 1 plus 1 gives us 2. And for the next one, we also have 1, and so 2 plus 1 gives us 3. And then the seventh, it has 2. So because we have 3 here, what we do is 2 plus 3 gets us 5. So moving onward, we'll get that pattern. And so letter B turns out to be the correct answer, because we have to maintain these numbers here, which are already given. Okay, now the problem really that I had was whether it was for the second set Actually, this is the group P, the answer group P, whether it was C or D. And if we put in the values, for example, I think that once we reach the 7th, we'll run into problems because the index won't be the same. Okay? So, for example, if it's N plus count I minus 1, and our N, we are now in the 7th, so our N is currently at 3 plus the count I minus 1, 7, 6, so that's 1. Therefore, 3 plus 1 gives us supposedly 4, but we don't get a 4 there. Now, if we use N as the value for index, then we'll find that, for example, we're now at 7. Let's see, if it's the count is at 7, the value is 2, okay? And then the, let me see, the index should be N, should be the value of N, this one, and we know that currently it's 3. So we get the 3 here, and then we add those two together. That's why the next N would be 5, okay? So turns out that this one, the one that I was thinking of, would be okay to a certain extent, but once we reach the 7th, it breaks down, and from there, what we have left would be N, and that's why we know that in this case, this one would be the correct answer. And again, I had to write these things down because I needed to see the set of choices and also have this group of arrays together to see the pattern. And from the pattern, can we identify what would be the correct answer? So I think if you had to do the back and forth, scroll up, scroll down a lot, I think it would be really confusing and really be something that would cause you some sort of dizziness if you attempt to answer it. And I think you got to have some way to be able to quickly see the pertinent parts of the description and also the answers that are available for you to choose from. Okay, so I think that should be enough for now. Thanks.